President Trump abruptly cancelled the meeting last month. Speaking at a business conference in Tel Aviv, Mr. Giuliani said Kim Jong-un got back on his hands and knees and begged for it, which is exactly the position you want to put him in. That was Rudy Giuliani there. Let's get more now on President Trump's talks with Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe. Dr. John Hemmings is Director of the Asia Studies Centre at the Henry Jackson Society in London. He joins us now. John, thanks so much for joining us here on the program. So essentially, Abe is going to Washington with a bag of concerns that he has, that he wants to raise before Tuesday's summit.
Yeah, his whole concern has been perhaps three different points. One is not to be cut out of the loop completely. He's the only one who hasn't mentioned, who hasn't met with Kim Jong-un out of all the different meetings that have occurred. Second is he wants to push forward the idea that the abductees issue is a shared allied concern. That's not clear from the U.S. side that that's something that takes parity with the missile and nuclear weapons negotiations. And third, I think he is probably also wanting to talk to Trump about the steel tariffs, which as they go into the G7 in Canada shortly after. So those three things are going to be taking up his concentration.
Does Japan currently, ahead of this summit, feel sidelined or abandoned by the United States?
There's definitely concern about it in the Japanese media, but I think to some extent we shouldn't over-egg it. I mean, at the end of the day, even if at the summit the abductees issue is not raised, the Japanese have the final card. North Korea is going to need to be, any deal that occurs, they're going to need reconstruction funding. They're going to need someone to help them rebuild.
And President Trump has said on a number of occasions that that will be, one of the people that will do that will be Abe and the Japanese.
I think that will be the moment when the Japanese say about those other abductees, where are they? So they, you know, it doesn't have to be now. And I think that's something that we've not seen yet. The Japanese still feel that they need to push it in as a multilateral option. But even if it doesn't, I don't think they've lost the case.
The other concern that the Japanese have is this line that the U.S. have been pushing, that, you know, the threat that the North Koreans pose to the United States. Do they feel like their concerns in terms of North Korea's nuclear weapons are not being taken into consideration?
Yes, but I think, you know, to some extent, if the alliance remains cogent, if the weapons are dealt with, that will also presumably have a knock-on effect for the ability of North Korea to threaten Japan.
So are they then on the same page?
They are. I think the primary issue will also be whether Abe feels that he's getting capital out of visiting Trump. Trump is, you know, the mogul businessman. He's treating everyone as if they were competing companies. And there's not that kind of alliance resonance that Abe expected from previous administrations, particularly on the steel tariffs. But I tend to think that's about midterms, and I think it's short term and very different from what's happening with the US and China.
How is Abe doing at home in terms of the polls and the Japanese public? Are they sort of happy with the way he's handling this whole situation?
He was doing very poorly. He's been the longest, I think one of the longest prime ministers in Japanese post-war history, so he's done extremely well. There was a scandal, long-running scandal over the past 2 years about, essentially, not to go into it too much, but corruption over perhaps selling land for government land for very cheap to a right-wing school. That was really ebbing away at his credibility, so he kind of needs this win. So the abductees issue is also how he came up as a political leader. He gets a lot of domestic support for it. So I presume that's also what's driving him to try to get that on the table.
And all eyes are on next Tuesday. John, always good to hear your thoughts here on the program.